get ready to match the stars. Joe Silver, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Esther Rowe, Richard Dawson, Fanning Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Joe, Brett, Charles, Fanny, Richard, Esther. Are you all quite ready?
Yes, quite.
Yes, thank you.
Looks marvelous.
Oh, it's kind of you to notice, Joe.
Thank you.
See me later in my dressing room, and I'll give you the tenor. All
right,
now let's say hello to Laura Callahan and Linda Abel. Laura's a champ. She's won a total of $950, and she's being challenged by Linda, and the game they played ended up in a tie. Linda has had her tie-breaking question. She has matched four of our celebrities, and we're about to give you your tiebreaker. But before we do that, we got a little business we want to pass along to you. This is it. Here we go. Let's see if we're going to break this tie. Bing. All right, Laura, there's yours. Four to tie, five to win. For Laura, Mildred said... She said, if that nosy broad Mrs. Olson ever comes snooping around my kitchen again, I'll stuff her head into the blank. That's what Mildred said. If that nosy broad Mrs. Olson ever comes snooping around my kitchen again, I'll stuff her head into the blank. You're the best because you're the first. There. You know who Mrs. Olson is?
Oh, we did before, but they're just
testing lines. No, you play now. Yeah. This is the tiebreaker.
Everybody plays, right?
Everyone plays in the tiebreaker.
Okay,
this is just one question for each of our civilians over there.
I'm finished.
Dear Mama.
Okay, finished there. Now we're all set.
Like
we'll come here and call on Laura Callahan.
Sure.
Mildred said, if that nosy broad Mrs. Olson ever comes snooping around my kitchen again, I'll stuff her head into the blank.
Coffee pot.
Okay. I guess everybody here has seen that commercial, eh? Joe?
Oh, except me. Right?
Except you?
Right.
Why?
If I don't do them, I don't watch them.
Oh.
No, I have her head in the oven.
In the oven?
Yes. Well, that's how it goes.
Okay.
Sorry
you didn't
about
see
that.
It. Brett?
Sorry, Laura.
No, darling, that's where I put mine on a bad day. That's not where you put Mrs. Olson. You take that rotten little nosy head of hers and you stick it in the percolator or any coffee pot handy.
Okay.
And you boil her to death.
That's enough. Get the wet sheets out for Brett.
Mind her own business.
What did you say?
Sometimes it frightens me so when you get that. I said coffee pot.
Coffee pot. Two for you, so at this moment the score is 4-2. As I walk by Esther, she says, I ain't gonna read mine. why ain't you gonna read yours?
Because you'll think I'm a meanie.
Why? You've never seen the commercial?
I wouldn't do this to dear Mrs. Olson, but...
Okay.
Just flush it right down there. Wrong commercial, right?
Yes. Yeah, now I guess she's too busy to watch television, you see.
That's the tidy bowl man, you see.
That's right.
He's already there.
Yeah, I guess he is. So are we, I might point out.
Snooping around my kitchen again, I'll stuff her head into the blank, and she said, coffee pot. Now you got a match of two remaining ones to stay in the business.
I said oven, though.
Oven. Okay. Now you hang around here for a moment or so while we talk to Laura. You're going to leave us now, but you'll be going with $950.
Thank you very much.
Did you have a good time?
I certainly did.
Splendid. Laura Callahan. Goodbye, my dear. Now, they're rolling this around for you. There it is. Big Money Super Match, where you can win over $5,000. Linda, you ready?
Oh, as ready as I'm going to be.
Okay. How many months pregnant are you?
I have two more to go.
Two more what?
Months.
Oh, two more months. Okay.
Oh, honey, that means you're 12 months.
That's right. Don't come out till I call you. All right, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Jim. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, $250 if you match that one, and if you hook up with the last one, you get $100. Whom do you call out?
Brett. What about? I hope that baby doesn't drop tonight because you're in terrible trouble. What about Jungle Jim?
Jungle Jim. There's
one. Richard.
Diamond Jim.
Diamond Jim.
Diamond Jim Brady.
Diamond Jim Brady. Big spender.
Fanny. Big Jim.
Big Jim. Who is it? Is
that's
that,
a toy.
It's a toy.
Don't you? Oh, no, no, no. Don't you remember Big Bad Jim?
That's
you?
No. Right.
Big Bad John.
Big Bad John.
No, that's the tidy bowl.
Oh, dear me. So you
no,
got...
you know what? I'm sorry. You know, that's true. I made a terrible mistake. I'd like to take it back and give her another one.
No, you can't do that. That's your answer. So you got Big Jim, Diamond Jim, and Jungle Jim.
Spelled G-Y-M, or isn't it?
Well, there is a device that children play in, which is called a jungle gym, you know, with pipes all connected together. But I don't know if you
there
have that in mind.
There is also a jungle gym.
There's a
gym
character
cartoon,
in a cartoon strip called Jungle Jim.
Oh, Johnny Weissmuller. Oh, it was very popular.
Really?
That was Tarzan.
No, no, he did Jungle Jim.
He did a series called Jungle Jim.
Oh, he did a series
of
series.
Yes. Oh,
listen. Would all of you lay out?
Oh, we're only trying to help.
Thanks.
Don't look at me. I haven't opened my mouth.
You got to make up your mind here.
This lady
what do you want?
Diamond
months.
Jim.
Diamond Jim.
That's what I thought first.
That's what you thought first. Okay, let's find out if Diamond Jim is up there, and if so, where? May we see the $100 response?
Big Jim.
Okay,
just a little emotion.
Alice, there is a Big Jim, after all.
There is now.
Now, we are looking for Diamond Jim. Here's a $250 response. Diamond Jim, you've got it, Linda. So, that gives you a total of $350 now. Audience, what's under the big one?
Jungle
Jim. Here's a $500 number. Jungle Jim it is. Who said that? Now, Linda, you've won $250. That means you play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. Now, but before we can give you that money, though, you got to match one of them here. Which one will it be?
Richard.
All right, Richard, you get ready to write.
I'm not going to play. She didn't give me a kiss for giving her Diamond Jim.
Oh. I was too busy holding
him. Better go over and give him a kiss. All right. Little kiss there for Richard. And here we go.
Remember your condition.
Stand on the... tape. I got the $2,500 question, which reads as follows. Follers, yes. Stay out of my life. Letter blank. That's L-E-T-T-E-R blank. Now, he's finished, Linda. We ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his. What do you say to that? Letter blank.
Opener.
Letter opener. Sounds good to me. We'll find out if it sounded good to Richard. She says that'll match her for $2,500, Richard.
All I could think of was a Beatles song.
The what?
The Beatles song. Letter B.
Oh, letter B.
Do you want to give me a kiss before I show you the card? It
I
might
will.
Bring you luck.
Come All right, here. It'll bring you luck.
Okay, let's see it.
Come here.
Did I get to see on this side? Okay. Come on.
Grand total of $2,850. Okay, while she's getting it all together, we'll spin a little message for you here, and then you hurry right back. Here we are. Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay, let's meet our new player, Rosalie Turner. How are you, Rosalie?
Fine.
Nice to have you with us.
Nice to be here.
good. Where's Rosalie Turner from?
Columbus, Ohio. And I've lived in California for 3 years.
Mm-hmm. What, do you work? Are you a student?
I'm a student at Performers Academy.
Okay. Well, good luck to you, Rosalie. Shall we begin?
Yep.
All right. Whoops. How could I miss that little button there? All right, Rosalie, A or B? It's up to you.
A.
A. Shall we begin?
Let's.
The Indian chief said, me put new brave in charge of smoke signals. Him dumb. Me tell you how dumb him is. Him send smoke signals in the blank. Hmm. They not so smart either. They no right.
I like Joe's answer, but I don't like his.
You finish. Good.
Do that again, Jim.
Me put new brave in charge of smoke signals. Him dumb. Him send smoke signals in the blank.
I just love the way you read.
Yes.
There's a man back here with a box of candy that keeps trying to lure me over there. Who is that?
Roger Domkowitz?
Yeah, and he has this big box of candy.
Yeah, well, he's not supposed to have it there. Hmm. Roger, I'm going to confiscate that box of candy.
Danny, yes. And I don't eat it because we're dieting.
That's right. Don't look over there. All right. Everybody ready?
Does everybody have an answer?
Charles,
I don't have an
we'll make one up.
Well, then listen, you're not. We're just ad-libbing here while
well,
you're doing
it. All right. Gee whizzakers.
Okay, here we go. Rosalie.
Uno momento.
What happened?
Well, just don't get testy. Oh.
She's our guest. We're here every week, but she's our guest. Oh,
that's very good.
I'm a slow thinker.
Yes.
That's nice.
Okay.
Testy, guesty.
Now, all right. Please.
Now, Rosalie. Indian chief said, me put new brave in charge of smoke signals. Him, dumb. Him send smoke signals in the blank.
Water?
In the water.
In the water.
Mm. Me no think him quite that dumb.
Well, if he'd had a water pipe, he might.
Mm. Right.
But no, this one was a different tribe. He sent them in the dark.
In the dark.
Well, I was going to say twilight, but then I didn't want to have to put up with that fight.
Yes.
So I just went right ahead and said dark.
Okay. Now, Charles.
It's still very dark.
Esther, what did you say? You don't like that answer?
It dark, too.
Did you have a better answer?
No.
No, all right.
Dark
okay. I thought I heard you say you didn't like that answer. Now, Richard.
Yeah? Who said that?
Me know him dumb, him send smoke signals in the water, according to Rosalie.
Dark is a childish term.
I say nighttime.
Nighttime. Fanny Flag, Fanny Flag.
Yes, darling.
What do you say?
I say I don't understand why they laughed at her. I myself wrote rain, which is water.
Rain? There's one. Okay. Are you ready for yours, Linda? This is it. George said to Horrible Hannah, this chocolate chip cookie tastes funny. And Horrible Hannah said, look close at that cookie. Those aren't chocolate chips. Those are blanks.
I have got the most wonderful answer.
I bet you have.
Oh, I just love my answer so much.
That is
good. I should throw that away.
Up to you.
One more, please.
Oh, that is.
George said to Horrible Hannah, this chocolate chip cookie tastes funny. And Horrible Hannah said, look close at that cookie. Those aren't chocolate chips. Those are blanks.
Oh, I love my answer.
Have you ever eaten a chocolate chip cookie?
Take a look at his stomach. He's eating 1,000 chocolate chip cookies.
Wait a minute.
Those aren't chocolate chips. Those are...
Charles!
Oh, dear. Well, I'll start walking over. Maybe by the time I get here, you'll finish. And he did.
I'm ready.
Linda, George said to Horrible Hannah, this chocolate chip cookie tastes funny. And Horrible Hannah said, look close at that cookie. Those aren't chocolate chips. Those are blanks.
Flies.
Flies. All right.
Well,
horrible, good, Joe? Horrible. Is that a good
one? It's good, but yeah. it's not good enough.
You're about to see two doozy of answers coming up.
I don't know. This is of the same family, but they had cockroaches or
cockroaches.
Bugs. Well, your horrible Hannah runs a terrible kitchen, that's all.
Sorry, Brett.
Tell the truth. Yeah. You hated my answer, right? But then you saw Joe's.
Right.
And now you think that cow chips is the best thing that's ever come out of the pot.
Charles?
I said bugs.
Bugs. All right. The top tier is a total disaster. Yes, total disaster.
This is the hippest answer.
We got a hip answer?
This is beautiful. All right.
Linda's looking for the answer, flies. What do you say?
I ain't got no flies, but I think it's a very imaginative answer. Polka dots.
Polka dots. Splendid.
That's a great answer.
Yes, those aren't chocolate chips, those are polka dots. Yes. Now, Richard.
I said son of cockroaches.
Cockroaches.
No, the sons.
All right.
Just the sons.
La cucaracha.
Da, 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 da.
La cucaracha.
Personally, here's what I'd like to say.
You're interrupting my song.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, I'd like to say that I don't understand. Cockroaches are rather large. Aren't we being technical here?
Yes.
All right. I said they're dreaded raisins.
Dreaded raisins.
I've mistaken raisins for chocolate chips and gotten disgusted, haven't you?
Dreaded raisins.
Didn't like raisins.
No, okay.
Hate raisins.
So at the end of round one, 1-0 in favor of Rosalie. Round two coming up, but first, this message. All right, here we go with round two. Rosalie, it's your choice.
A again.
A. One person does not play, that's Fanny. You lay out. The rest of you, if you would, respond to this. At the amusement park, Jerry said, whatever you do, don't go on the chicken ride. They take your money, then they blank you.
And I have a perfect answer. No, I don't know whether it's going...
That's it.
Now, if Fanny were playing this game, she'd have this answer.
Let me see.
Right.
Let me see.
That's it. What? Okay.
Wouldn't you have this answer?
No.
Oh. What do you have now?
Yeah. Well,
Charles is ready, Brett.
That's. Oh, all right. Okay. Hi, Jake.
Just write something down there.
That's
okay,
club
ready,
soda.
Everybody.
You
now,
devil.
Rosalie Turner. At the amusement park, Jerry said, whatever you do, don't go on the chicken ride. They take your money, then they blank you.
Pluck.
Then they pluck you. Because they take your money, then they pluck you. What do you say?
Absolutely right. I said Fanny would have that answer. They would pluck you. Absolutely.
And Brett, what do you say?
Do you think I said pluck?
Well, I would hope so, because that'll match her.
I said fry.
Fry. Charles?
Pluck.
Naturally. Okay, that's what she wants. And Esther. First they take your money, then they blank you. Rosalie said pluck. You got one.
Oh, no.
No.
Anyway.
But you're getting close.
I came pretty close. Pluck.
Pluck. Oh, you got it. All right, Richard.
Can't come any closer than that.
There. Pluck. Five for you. So that means when we come to your question, you'll have to match five to tie, six to win. But before we do that, we want to do a little business with you, America. Pay attention. Now, we got 30 seconds and we got a minute.
30 seconds to the black.
30 seconds to the black. Okay. Is there anything anyone has to say?
Well, I do. That's nothing personal.
Right. What?
I just did 8 candid camera shows. It'll be on this fall.
Terrific. Where are you, Charles?
We'd like to order some Chinese food.
You're ordering Chinese food. That's enough. Listen, next time we get together, we'll have these celebrities on this stage.
Clifton Davis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Rona Barrett, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
We ordered an egg roll for you last year. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn, join us next time for Match Game 75. Goodbye. Wow.